Japan's traditional inn, ryokan, is worth trying. By staying a night over, bathing, and eating their food, you can have first-hand experience in Japanese culture and history. But how can we choose the right ryokan? This video gives you 8 essential tips. By using Inn Tamai in Tamatsukuri Hot Spring as an example. First, we tend to forget, but the size of the inn is important. There are bigger inns, like this in the same town, has more than 100 rooms, often catering to bigger groups, having larger facilities such as banquet rooms. But the smaller inn has its own charm, and I see people there who'd provide intimate care and attention, showing warm hospitality. Satsuki means the fifth month or azaleas blooming around that time of the year. This inn was built more than 110 years ago during the late Meiji period. I love ryokan with a long history. We can experience the historical beauty, see the cute antique cabinets. We can't easily find this kind today. Look, on the top of the table, a local cake filled with a moist white bean paste, which has been loved since 1967. Whoa, the red round table has unique details. My point is, a ryokan with a history often has distinct characteristics to enjoy, not just because it's old, but its architecture, furniture, and landscape that the inn carefully maintains and shares with us. I really appreciate that. One lovely aspect of ryokan is their Japanese-style bath. You cannot find it at a typical Western-style hotel. But what is a Japanese-style bath? Here's a quick overview. A Japanese-style bath is separated by a washing area and a soaking area. At the ryokan, you might see indoor and open-air bathing areas, and in either case, you must wash your body first and then rinse before getting into the bathtub. Other basic etiquettes that I see people follow, like don't jump in, no underwear, don't soak your towels or long hair in the bathtub. It's also dangerous to take a bath if you are super drunk. And after taking a bath, people usually dry their bodies to prevent the changing room floor from being wet. Bathing facilities are important elements when choosing a ryokan. Public bathtubs are usually much larger than the average type you see at home, so you can stretch your arms and legs, feeling streams of hot water. If you like a sauna, see if they have it. I love going back and forth between hot and cold baths and their sauna, so I always check if there is a cold bath. But you might also want to see if the inn has a private bath, which you can rent it all by yourself. No worries about being naked or having tattoos, because it's only you. Or enjoy a relaxing moment with your significant other, family, or close friends. It's usually around 1,000 yen to 3,000 yen for 1 hour. Some ryokan let their guests use it for free, like in Sowan in Yunokawa Hot Spring. Another important point, when I'm choosing a ryokan, I always check if they have an open-air bath. Why? Because you can feel nature.
So nice. I can feel the buzz. Spring bird is sleeping.
Nice breeze, seasonal trees, and flowers. or even snow. So wonderful. You might think no way to take a bath in snowy outdoors, but it's so warm in the hot spring tub, and cold air cools off your head and whatever outside the hot water. You can even enjoy snowfalls and winds. In Japan, yukimiburo, or bathing while viewing snow, is a loved and special experience. Water quality for bathing is an important aspect when choosing a ryokan. Tamae Inn has Kensen Kakenagashi or simply Kakenagashi style, which means hot spring continuously overflowing without being diluted by water. Not many places have it, but it's really worth trying it out because different hot springs have different healing effects, and Kakenagashi waters usually have stronger effects. You'll see lots of minerals like this, which is cool. Tamae Inn has its own spring source gushing 31 meters underground in their property, so they can offer 100% Kakenagashi. The hot spring is transparent, 55 degrees Celsius. It contains radium, iron, salt, and sulfur.
It's really nice. Beautiful.
It is said to be effective for rheumatism, health issues concerning women, pains in the nerve pathway, problems related to digestion, and skin diseases. Such detailed information is difficult to gather only from travel agencies' sites. So after finding a favorite ryokan, it's good to go to their homepage and investigate more.
This bathtub has really cute tile too, like 5 won coin or something. Especially I like the clock statue. It's like just looking up to the sky.
Some ryokan provide guest rooms with a private open-air bath, like this at Tamae Inn. The advantage of choosing this type is that you are guaranteed to have a private outdoor soaking time, anytime you want, day and night, and next morning, without hustling to reserve a private bath with extra fees. It's usually more costly to reserve this kind of room, but if the difference between one with it and one without it is not too much, it's totally worth it to pay a bit more to have open air private bath in your room. Although some ryokan allow overnight stays without meals, they usually provide their guests dinner and breakfast. Almost always, I go for a plan with meals because after taking a bath, I do not want to hustle to get ready and go out. And you know, we never know how the weather would be like. I just want to have a relaxing meal, staying clean in a casual cotton kimono called yukata. I got this yukata at Inn Tamae. For men, they provide cool blue yukata. Ryokan often provide seasonal dishes by using regional specialties. Why should we miss such a great opportunity to try local food and drinks, as well as stories behind them? It's important to investigate what type of meals are often served at a ryokan before booking. Ryokan's typical dinner is a multi-course banquet dinner, kaiseki, during which different dishes from an appetizer to a dessert are served. Most of the time, it's Japanese food, but includes some Western dishes like a steak or a stew. For example, Inn Tamae included herb-grilled Japanese Spanish mackerel, squash, beans, and lotus roots with delicious ratatouille. Although its rules are flexible, kaiseki dishes are served one by one in a certain order, so guests can enjoy each item's fresh flavor and texture. However, I also see many ryokan provide a lot of items at once in the beginning and add more later. I personally like to have each dish one by one, but I know that some guests want to have multiple items at once, without waiting and without worrying about a strict order. Intimate dinner follows the style of providing many items at once and adding more later. Some ryokan let you choose a Western full course too. For example, at Yamatoya Honten in Dogo Hot Spring, Ehime, I found their French course wonderful and liked it more than their traditional Japanese course. Some ryokan also offer buffet-style meals, so it's important to check different options and pick your favorite type. Another tip. Remember to check where exactly you are having dinner and breakfast. Why? It's because, depending on the plan, your meal location could change, which usually gives you quite different experiences. For example, it could be the ryokan's common dining area. If it's a shared space with other customers, you have less privacy and could be noisy. If you prefer a lively banquet atmosphere, however, that might be a good choice for you. That being said, well, it really depends on your priority. Some ryokan provide compartments or private rooms to give their guests more privacy. Such a room is usually quite nice, so if there is a choice, I often pick one. Some ryokan offer heyashoku, which literally means meals served in your own guest room, like room service. You just relax and wait for your kaiseki dishes to be delivered to your room. Many Japanese people like this heyashoku style because it gives more privacy and a relaxing atmosphere. One caveat for heyashoku. Traditional ryokan guest rooms are like this, which means that you probably sit on the floor during the entire meal. In a restaurant setting, you have a higher chance to sit on a chair. So please think pros and cons and choose a plan based on your preferences. Another difference between ryokan and Western hotels is that at most ryokan, you take off shoes at the building entrance, or if not, at the entrance of your guest room, like visiting someone's house in Japan. Ryokan usually provide slippers and tabi socks. Towels and toothbrushes are also provided, and usually a hairband and a shaver are provided too. Many places, a hair dryer is provided at each guest room. You often see multiple dryers in a public bath changing room, but you might want to check. If you are taking public transportation, please check whether ryokan pick you up at the nearby train station or bus stop. It's important because if they offer such a service, why do you pay expensive taxi fees? Some ryokan requires a pickup reservation, so it's good to arrange that in advance too. Accessibility. Historical ryokan is such a charm, but it might not have elevators or wheelchair access to all the spaces, so it's good to check. Price. Of course, who doesn't care how much you have to pay, right? Depending on the ryokan, a one-night stay, including dinner and breakfast, could be as low as 6,000 yen and could go up more than 50,000 yen. But in many cases, ryokan with hot springs are in the range between 15,000 yen to 30,000 yen. Prices are usually listed per person, not per room. And if there are more people staying in one room, more discounts you can get. And yep, weekday stays are usually cheaper. Even at the same ryokan, bigger rooms with more facilities tend to be expensive. For example, let's compare different rooms for one night at Inn Tamai with two meals. If two people stay in one room during the week, it's around 16,000 to 20,000 yen per person. But the room with an open air bath in the beautiful Japanese garden is more, around 30,000 yen. So these eight aspects are what I care about. But each of you must have different priorities and interests. So I also want to hear them. If you have any comments, please share with me. Thank you for watching. I look forward to seeing you in the future episodes.